screwed back then. We're talking about life, living it, and enjoying it. You better enjoy your life, bro, while you're still here. Enjoy it to your fullest ability and do not let anything bring you down. Don't forget to chase
that money and don't
be a broke boy. I'm not saying chase it. At least have some money around you so when the opportunity comes to spend it, you're able
to spend it. And I'm telling you, you have to have some money
on you for when the opportunity comes to make more of it as well. Because many people get into that lifestyle of always spending money on shit they don't need. Bro, I want you to spend your time at home. Don't be always going out. Save your fucking money, bro.
Save that cash. Because once that opportunity
comes for you to multiply what you have, and you don't have shit to spend to multiply, you're gonna be
in the fucking dead. You're gonna be dead in the water. You're gonna be on the fucking rocks, bleeding. That's why I love to save my money.
Even if I know I can spend it. I don't. I really don't. First of all,
if you live in a country like the United States, you gotta pay your fucking taxes. You don't pay your taxes,
you don't save at least
25 to 50% of what you made, they will come for your ass.
Especially when you tell them you don't have any money, they will get your ass. Then you're gonna be stuck paying fucking payments because you're behind on taxes. Now, when you're behind on fucking taxes, guess what? You went from paying, what, 20, 30%?
And you couldn't even pay it. Now you gotta pay 20, 30% on top of the new
money you're making. So it's more like 60% at this point, 50 to 60% of
your fucking income. Yeah, it's not great.
Now let's say you miss out on those payments. Now you're
paying upwards of 80,
maybe even 100%. You might not even make any fucking
money that year. Just because you paid it all to taxes.
It's crazy how the system works. It's crazy how they get your ass. But hey, don't let them fucking get you. That's why you're here. That's why you're here. You guys are going to see the whole journey behind the fucking scenes. I forgot to upload my organic dropshipping content. I just want to let you guys know, organic dropshipping works. You guys can make money doing organic dropshipping.
It's simple.
It's fucking simple as fuck. You just got to stick through with your product. That's all I'm going to say. Find a product you like to use to record with. Record with it for like a month or two and you should blow up if your videos were decent. And I'm not saying your videos have to be good.
They just have to be decent. And here's a quick tip. Find a competitor and copy everything they do. What they do in the video, what the hook of the video is, the title, the hashtags,
everything they do, do with your product. And you have to have a similar or the same product or a similar hook. And the same thing with hooks and shit like that.
But now most of you guys know,
well, you don't know, I'm switching over from that bullshit. Organic was nice. You the fucking $100 days, $200 days. And that's what I was able to do. I've seen people do upwards of $1,000 days plus. But I don't think organic is very sustainable. Many people beg to differ and can argue about me on that subject. Maybe because you're selling a course. I don't sell any fucking courses, nor will I sell a course. The only time I'm going to be selling a course is if you DM me and ask to learn, and I'll give you some fucking options, and I'll tell you what to do. And then your
dumbass is probably going to be like, Cameron,
can you teach me? And I'm going to be like,
yeah, send me a band and maybe I'll teach you. But right now I'm not teaching
shit because I don't know shit. So when you see me post a fucking $10,000 day plus, maybe come and DM me on Instagram. Maybe I got some shit for you.
But until you see that, do not go asking
nobody to teach you nothing. Don't go asking nobody. That's the one thing I fell into. A problem I fell into was learning from people that didn't know shit.
You might learn from somebody that knows
a little bit, and that person might take you a little bit further in your journey. But do you want to learn from a nigga that knows nothing or a little bit? Or do you want to learn from the person who's actually being successful?
And mind you, I've met
motherfuckers out here in this e-commerce space that are
making upwards of millions a month to
guys doing 100K days. Yeah, $100,000 days. And you're like, damn, that's crazy. But damn, bro. Look at it like this. Today I watched a boxing match. Francis Ngannou versus Ngannou versus this guy Joshua. And he got his ass whooped. But hear me this. Listen to this. The guy made 50 mil in one day. That's one mil. How much would that be? what's 50 divided 365? He made like 300K for every day of the fucking month of the year, basically. So dude made a fuck ton of money. A lot. Now, would you rather do that, get your ass beat for 50 mil, or learn how to make 50 mil on autopilot even after you don't have the ability to get your ass beat
or to beat somebody else's ass? I pick the latter. You know, most of those guys in those fights are getting sponsored by people who own brands, people who own companies, because these people pay the money to get their company shown on these large events. And I want to be one of those companies. I am going to be one of those companies. And you guys have seen my change in mind, my change in life. I'm just going to tell you right now, don't let that shit bring you down. Don't let people bring you down. Don't let your emotions bring you down. Stick in the gym, fucking work out, get those fucking gains, you know what I'm saying? Get those gains. Keep going, bro. Keep going. This is only a few videos in.
And yeah,
I love spread my mindset, my mind, my mental mind space, and what I believe in. But at the same time, you gotta remember you live in a system that was created by other people before you. And if the system works, do not change it. And it works. It works as long as you work. You know what I'm saying? The system works as long as you work. Don't forget that.
It won't work if you're not working.
Damn straight.
It's either you go and become autistic and collect the autistic check, right?
Or you can stay a normal ass nigga
and make as much as you want. That's how they get you, bro. That's how they get you. For many people out here, I even thought about joining the military. But
that's always supposed to be a
last option. And to be honest with you, I wasn't at my last option. I told myself, I came here in the mirror,
and I looked at myself, I was like, yo, Cameron,
you don't get this job, you gotta join the military. And I, luckily, bro, I got the job.
I got hired. Starting tomorrow,
I'm gonna go turn in everything, and we're gonna figure this shit out.
Now you guys gonna see me go from a broke boy
to a millionaire
and a billionaire very quickly. I'm not gonna say quickly because this isn't a get rich quick scheme.
Nobody's getting rich quick here.
This is
slow and steady
wins. It's the fucking race. So hopefully this year I can hit at least 10K. 10K this year. That's the goal. 10K. And I wanted to hit
$1 million by 18. That is the end goal. By 18, I'm making $1 million, and I'm making $1 million at the age of 18 selling products to my online customers. But you gotta go slow first. You gotta hit $100 first. And I've hit like, what is it?
I hit one band.
Organic dropshipping in 1 month.
But guess what?
That one band is not shit. Yeah, it's like minimum wage, bro. But still,
if I was working a day job, I would've made more. And what's the fucking point? It doesn't add up. It really doesn't add up. I was working 10-hour plus days
and still made a band.
And I was working damn near every day. But here's the thing though. Once you work 10-hour days for
4 days, you got enough footage to last you the whole month. So I really only worked about 4 days.
To make a band?
It depends what kind of person you are. I didn't like it though. I didn't fucking like it. The whole...
Probably research the whole accounts. One account gets fucked up, you gotta get a new account. Your phone gets fucked up because of the IPs. Whole lot of excuses, whole lot of shit, whole lot of just bullshit.
Once your IP gets banned, fuck, you're fucked, man, you're dead in the water.
Then now there's these new strategies going around
that you have to create fucking, you have to create theme pages
related to your product.
Yeah, I didn't want to go through with that. I really didn't. That's why I always, in the back of my head, in the front of my mind, I've always thought about ads and all the winners. In the e-com space, all the big guys, they're not out here fucking just doing organic, bro. Organic is like running a brand. You have your organic Instagram post, your social media content, boom, right? That builds trust. But then guess what's gonna bring in the sales? Even though organic can bring in your sales without running advertisements, don't get me wrong. At the end of the day though, what's gonna be making that consistent bread when you want it and when you want it now is fucking ads, and it's not gonna just happen like that in a flick of a finger, bro. But just know, you spend some money today, you're gonna get results the next morning.